second part to epsilon of g, that could also be done. But that is the Venus that introduced now. When angle is multiplied by variable is multiplied by any coefficient, we divide the integral after the integration by that coefficient. That is the integration. We have discussed it a number of times. Now let's talk about question number 14. The question number 14 is is 0 to pi by 2. Limit 0 to pi by 2. Okay, cos square x now. Now this is cos square x dx. Okay, so these are the cos formula now. So we know that this is cos square x now. You know that since cos square 2x, or let me take here theta, or okay, so this is 1 plus cos 2x. Okay, since we know that this cos 2 theta is equal to 2 cos square theta minus 1. From this we have taken, or 1 plus cos 2 theta equal to 2 cos square theta, or 1 plus cos 2 theta upon 2 equal to cos square theta. This value we have to substitute. In place of this, we can substitute this value to 0 to pi by 2. This is nothing but 1 plus cos 2x upon 2 into dx. This is the value of cos square x. We can just integrate this. So let me take 1.2 common again. Okay, so this is sign of integration 0 to pi by 2. This is dx on the 1 into dx, dx plus sign of integration is cos 2x 0 to pi by 2. Let's integrate them. 1.2 x here, and the limits are 0 to pi by 2. Plus sine, again sine 2x upon 2, integration 0 to pi by 2. This will be again sine pi 0. The answer is same, 0, 1 upon 2, integration pi by 2. Minus 0 plus 0. We substitute the lower limit. In place of x, we have substitute 0. 0. Okay, then plus sine 0, sine pi, 2 into pi by 2. That means pi only. Sine pi 0, minus sine 0, 2 into 0 upon 2. In both ways, it's 0. Again, it is pi by 4 answer. So these are 0s. So plus 0, minus 0, nothing. The only answer is pi by 4. Okay, so answer pi by 4 again. This is a similar type of question because the value of cos square x, sin square x, we can substitute in terms of cos 2x or cos 2 theta. That is what the answer is. This is the same answer as the question number 13. Now, let's talk about 15th question. Question number 15, what is it? Okay, this is. Okay, now question number 15. Question number 15 is 0 to pi. Now this is cos qx dx. Now we know that what is cos qx means. We know that cos 3 theta is equal to 4 cos q theta minus 3 cos theta. This is the formula for cos 3 theta. For this value equal, therefore 4 cos q theta is equal to, this value will come to the side, that means cos 3 theta plus 3 cos theta, or cos q theta equal to cos 3 theta plus 3 cos theta upon 4. This value we have to substitute here, is 0 to pi. Cos 3x plus 3 cos x upon 4 into dx. So in the two parts we can do this, but directly we can integrate. No need of substitution here. The 0 that we take 1.4 common. First we 0 to pi cos 3x dx that is 3 upon 4 sine of integration second part 0 to 5 units cos x dx. In this case dx can be substituted as t substitution, but directly we can the integration of this will be what? Cos 3x means sine 3x, sine 3x upon 3. The integration will go limits are 0 to 5, substitute the limits. Finally, we have not changed in any new variable. This is plus 3 upon 4, which is sine x upon 3. And it's up sine x only, because no coefficient of x is here, only one is there. This is limit 0 to 5. In both the cases, it is 0, 1.4 sine 3 pi is pi into any number. 1 pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 0, sine 3 pi into sine 3 pi minus sine pi upon 3 is also there. So into 3. Sine 0, 3 into 0, over limit is 0. Both are 0, 3 upon 4 common, sine pi minus sine 0. So in both the cases, 0, sine 3 pi 0. 0, 1.12 into 0, 0, plus 3 upon 4 into 0, 0, 0 is the answer to you any solution, mean answer is 0, means 0. Question number 15, we have done. Let's talk about 16 question, then the question. Now question number 16. Okay, question number 16. What I just said. Question number 16, sign of integration. It is 0 to pi by 2 cos 4s dx. Okay, this is cos 4s dx. Now we can again write it as pi by 2 cos square s whole square into dx. Now we know that 0 to pi by 2 is cos square, and we just substitute the value, this is cos 2 upon 1 2, we whole square into dx. So, cos cube x, we could do it in that way also, as cos square x into cos square x, 1 to be substituted as sine square x, the same thing. Let's further square it. So this is 1.4 after squaring. Okay, limits are 0 to pi by 2. Let me divide it into 1 plus cos square 2x. Let's 2 into cos 2x. We have square, we have whole square. Open the whole square of this. 1 plus cos 2x whole square. Cos square x is this. That whole square, cos 4 is. Now this is further substituted. What is the one value of this? 0 to pi by 2. 1 is okay. Cos square x, cos square. It will be 1 plus cos 4x. 2.2. Because cos square 2 is similarly. And we substitute this angle by the word here by here the angle here by x. So that twice is here angle. It will be 4x. So plus 2 into cos 2x. 1.4 we have taken. Only this value is the integrator self represented. 1.4 but first one. Sign of integration. Okay, we take 1.4 out. 0 to 5 by 2 into the 180 dx plus sign. Again, well, they could be added 1.2 plus 1. That means it is 3 by 2. Let me write here 3 by 2 also. This is 3 by 2 into 2. Okay, so these two values are 3 by 2. But this value is only. Okay, so dx is 1 plus 1, just 1.2 plus 1, and 3 by 2. But we have to multiply to this angle. Now, the second part is cos 4x. Third part in this case. Cos 4x. 1.8 × 2 × 4 × 8 × dx 0 × 5 by 2. This dx separated. Plus this one. Plus this will be 2 upon 4 × 1.2. 2 upon 4. That means 1.2 × 0 × 5 by 2. I separated them. Cos 2x and dx. Now directly we can integrate it. It will be 3 upon 8. It is s limits are 0 to pi by 2. So this is 1.8. Cos 4x means sin 4x upon 4. Limits are 0 to pi by 2. Okay, so this is. Okay, in the previous case it was pi by 2 or something. What was that? Question was pi. Okay. In the 15th question it was pi only. I'm just thinking about that. If it is a pi by 2, then sine 2 pi means 3 pi was sine 3 pi, or sine 3 pi was 3 pi by 2. That means it could be a value of, or something means it could be value 1. But in this case, that was pi by pi only in case of 15th question. In this case, it is pi by 2 only. Okay, so this integration is this much. Now let me take the last one. This part, this is sine 2x upon 2 limits are 0 to pi by 2. We are not changing any limits or no substitution here. Directly we are done this. Now this is pi by 2. That means 3 upon 3 pi by 16. The first part. Then second part will be 0 minus 0. So that's 0. We are not substituting. This one, 1.8. This is pi by 2 means 2 pi, sine 2 pi is 0, sine 2 pi upon 4, because when we substitute in place of x as pi by 2, it is 4 into pi by 2, that means 2 pi, whenever sine pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, 0, it will be 0 here, this is minus sine 0, so 0 substituted in place of x, so 4 and 0, 0, so sine 0 is 0, this is sine 0 upon 4. Okay, so this is. There are two parts here, this is 1.4 here. Sine again pi. This is sine 2 into pi by 2, that means sine pi minus sine 0. In both cases it is 0, this is also 0. Only 3 pi by 16 is the answer. All are zeros. Only first part is the 3 pi by 16. This is the answer here. This one. Sine 2 pi 0, so this is 0, this is 0. 1.8 into 0, 0. 1.4 into 0 is 0. That, all these two parts are 0. This part is left over. 3 pi by 16 is the answer then. So this is the answer. Question number 16, we have done here. Let's talk about 17 question. Question number 17 and others. Now question number 17. Let me get it. Okay, so question number 17 is minus 0 to 1 is dx upon px plus e raised to the power minus x. Okay, now if I convert it as 0 to 1, if I write it as this is dx upon px plus 1.3x, okay, so it will be 0 to 1 dx after taking LCM. You come in the numerator also. Dx into dx upon e to power 2x plus 1. Okay, so this is the value. Now if I substitute ex equal to, now that ex, now this is ex over square equal to 3. Therefore ex into dx equal to dt is implied that after differentiation, you will get ex into dx. Ex into dx upon dt equal to 1. Now, what are the limits here? If I substitute the limits, when x equal to 1, b or 1 is this one, so t equal to e on this, we will call 1 a. Okay, and then x equal to, or even x equal to b, x equal to 1, then this t equal to, when x equal to 0, then t is equal to e raised to 0, that is 1. So 1 to P, limits are. Limits are 1 to, yeah, 1 to E. This is dt, ex, dx, dt. So this value ex, dx, and dt, that is dt upon 1 plus t square. Why t square? This is ex whole square. That means e 2x power. This db value is e to power x. This is ex whole square, that means t square. T square. It is nothing but tan inverse t. Limits are 1 to e. So finally, value is tan inverse e. We do not know what the value of this. This is tan inverse e. And for 10 was 1. 10 was 1 is 4. 10 is e minus 10 was 1 is for 5 by 4. Angle is 5 by 4. Then 10 was 10 pi by 4 is 1. That means 10 was 1 is 5 by 4. It's 5 by 4. This is answer e. 10 was e is not the value. This is answer. The final answer is. Because we have to change the limits. Changing the limits will not force us to go back to the same variable x. No, no need of that because we have changed the limits also. This is the important information regarding the integrals, that we have to convert the limits also in the new change variable. If the variable is changed, substitute. Okay? The x is substituted for t variable, the new variable t. Convert the limits also in the variable t, the interval what is given to us, that will be something different or maybe similar if the there is no change in the limits. Okay, so this is the answer here. Question number 17 we have done. And let's talk about 18th question. Question number 18, say. Question 18 is this one. Okay, so this is 18th question, 0 to 1. This is 1 minus x upon 1 plus x, okay, dx. 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 Okay, so if we substitute nothing but between, take it into 2 base. How can we? In it as substituted that, let me take minus sign common, or it is minus sign common if I take it minus sign common here, it will be x minus 1. So we have to do x plus 1, let me add plus 1 in my n minus 1 again, okay, into dx divided by 1 plus 1, limits are 0 to 1 into dx. That means what? Minus sign of integration. X plus 1 is x plus 1 we have taken. Minus 2 will be separate. X plus 1 upon x plus 1 is the limit. We have 0 to 1 limits. Minus sign. And this minus sign 2 will be plus 2. Sign of integration. So this is minus 1 and this plus 2. Okay, then. Okay, so minus 2, I'm sorry, it's minus 2, plus 1 we have taken away. Minus 2 will be left over in this case. So this minus sign will be common. Okay, so it will be then plus 2 minus 1. Okay, no problem. It's like plus 1, it's minus 2, plus 2. 0 to 1 limits, it's 1 upon x. This is 1 only, this is minus sign dx, 0 to 1 limits. Plus sign 2 will be. Okay, so if I add this to this, we minus 2 x plus 1, minus x plus 1, okay, no problem. That's the same, right? So this is the conversion of this. Now, we can integrate this value 0 to 1, 1 upon 1 plus x into dx. If I write here 1 plus x to the t, what is the difference? But it can be directly done as log of 1 plus x, no problem. Okay, so it is x1 integrating there, therefore integration is x here, and then it has 0 to 1 plus 2 into this. This is integration x log 1 plus x. Okay, which is limits are 0 to 1. Let me substitute the limits here with minus 1. 0 is 0, plus 0 was x 0, plus 2 into log of limits are 1 plus 1 plus minus sign, which is log 1 only, because 0 will be substituted to log 1 is 0. The finally, the value is minus 1 plus 2 into log of 3, which is minus 0. This is 2 log 2, that means log of 4 to square plus minus 1. This is nothing but log of 4 minus 1 is the answer. Okay, so log, this is log 4 minus 1 is the answer for question number 18. Okay, so this is what we have for question number 18. Now let's talk about 19th question number 19. Question number 19 is about, let me talk about this. This is question 19 here. 0 to 1 limits, this is x of 1, and the root 1 plus x square into a. Okay. So here let's talk about the big mistake on x square. 1 plus x square into a. We need to differentiate it with respect to b. Twice x into bx equal to dt. You have to change that for x bx equal to dt upon 2. Limits are what? Change the limit also. When x equal to 1, upper limit, when x equal to 1, or at x equal to 1, t equal to 1 plus 1, that is 2. And when x equal to 0, lower limit, then t is equal to 1, 1 only, because here we have 0 in place of x, 1 plus 0 is square, that is 1 only, 1 to 2. Limits are 1 to 2. Okay, and it was dt upon 2, divided by under root t. This can be taken in the numerator, 1.2, 1.2. Let me take out of sign of integration this. And this is nothing but t raised to the power minus half into dt. Okay. T raised to the power minus half. Okay. So finally, this value will be 1.2. Okay, well, that's 1.2, now let me integrate this. It's t raised to the power minus half plus half. So plus 1. It is plus 1 upon minus half plus 1. The limits are 0 to 1. So it will be like this is half positive. This positive half will be mentioned up. So only 1 t raised to the power half is there in the numerator. Okay. 0 to 1 limits. 1 only, because 1 power half is 1, 1 power half minus 0 power half, that means 1 only, 1 not only, 1 is 1. 1 is the answer here. This is the question number 19. 1 is the answer of question 19. Okay, so that is question number 19. Okay. 1 to 2 limits. A bit of the limits here. So the limits were 1 to 2. It was 1 to 2 limits, we converted 1 to 2 limits, which helps in 1 to 2 limit and 1.2 divided by 2, that was okay. And here it was t raised to the power minus half, that means I'm sorry, I think that the limits are not substituted the same. It was what? Okay, this is dt into dt. The final answer will be 1.2 integration of this e to the power positive half upon positive half. This is 1.2 limits. Here, 0 is not there. I'm sorry. This is 2 times left. This is 3 to the power half. 2 to the power half minus 1 power half. And then under root 2 minus 1. Sorry, this is the answer. I just forgot about the limits of things. I just take 1.0 to 1 limits only. Sorry. This is what the answer, under root 2 minus 1 is the answer. Okay, sorry for this. This is the answer, under root 2 minus 1 of 19th question. Because I just forgot about the limits. Limits I took the previous limits, not the changed limits. When I applied the change limit, answer was under root 2 minus 1, that is the correct answer. Question 19 is done. Now let's talk about 20 question. Question number 20 is 0 to 8 limits. And the under root is a square minus x square into a. Now this, let's talk about substitution. We have done this to substitution in case of Laplace functions. But let me do it again. Here, x equal to here. Substituting x equal to a sine theta, a sine t. Okay. A sine t here. This we have to substitute. A sine t. Therefore, differentiating in the respect of t, it will be dx equal to a into cos t into dt. Okay, this is the value of dx. And the limits, let me change. That's equal to a here, limits. In case when, or at x equal to a, and x equal to a, upper limit, then if a is equal to a sine t, or sine t equal to 1, that means sine pi by 2. And pi by 2 is equal to k is equal to pi by 2. This is pi by 2 limit. And 0, when x equal to 0, then sine 0, so t will be 0, and at x equal to 2, nothing that here, at x equal to 2, and at x equal to 0, t 0, because sine t equal to 0, and 0 is for 0 and 0, so it is t 0, limits are 0 to pi by 2, then under root a square minus a square sine square, t, let me take into a cos t into dt, okay, 0 to pi. From this a, it will be out of the square root, and then we will be 1 minus sine square t into a cos t into dt. That means it will be a square, a into a square, 0 to pi. Sorry, this is pi by 2. Here it is sine cos t. Cos t into cos t into dt. Now again converting cos t. This is 0 to pi by 2. Cos square t is 1 plus cos dt upon 2. Let me change it. 1 plus cos 2t upon 2 into dt. That means integrating this dx square. And 1.2 that we take to common. 1.2 common. And the first part we do is sign of integration. 0 to pi by 2. And this is dt only. So 1 into dt. Plus sign of integration 0 to pi by 2. It is cos 2t into dt. Cos 2t into dt is the second part. Okay, so this is, let's integrate this a square sine of t. This is t 0 to, then it's written that 0 to pi by 2. Plus sine, cos 2t means sine 2t. On 2, limits are 0 to pi by 2. Okay, the same limit. So this is a square upon 2. Okay, here it is pi by 2. So in place of t, we have to substitute pi by 2 first, then 0. So t 0 is 0. Means only pi by 2. The first part is pi by 2 0. Pi upon plus sine. This is sine 2 into pi by 2 is sine pi is 0. And sine 0 is also 0. Both cases 0. 0 minus 0. Okay, so answer will be nothing but pi a square pi into a square upon 4. This is the answer. Pi a square upon 4 is the answer for question number 28. Okay, let me solve this. Question number 28 we have solved here. So let's talk about the next question. Which is 21st. And question number 21st. What did you say? Okay, that is there. 21st question is. And after this, A to B is log x upon s. 0 to, sorry, 2 to dx. Okay, so let me let substitute log x equal to 3, therefore 1 upon x dx equal to dt. Limits are what? Let me change the limits. For the limits, when upper limit b and x equal to b, t is equal to log b. So upper limit is log b and at the x equal to a, t equal to log a. The limits are, this is log a lower limit and log b is the upper limit. This is log t is t we have assumed. T into dt. Integration will be nothing but t square upon 0 to, sorry, limits are log a log b. Therefore, this is 1.2 we have taken common. Log b whole square minus